So I am connected in the sense that I am half Palestinian, yes.
And what do you make of what's been happening on campus?
It's just very unfortunate, and it got to a place that it shouldn't have got to. Like, it's too fast, too much. It could have been completely avoided.
You know, it was actually shocking, right? I've lived in New York for most of my life. I've actually, you know, spent some time on campus. I'm about to graduate. And I've never seen police action of the scale that I saw yesterday night.
They have just made access into Hamilton Hall through the window there.
It's very unfortunate that things got a little bit violent and the NYPD and the squad force had to be brought in.
People who were involved in that and some of the supporters say this was a necessary step, just as it was necessary in 1968 for them to occupy the building, Hamilton Hall. They say that if you really want to make a difference, you have to sometimes break a few rules.
Part of that is true, but I did see like some Jewish students also getting hurt in the process, and I just wanted to show my support that, listen, right, I don't agree with what they were doing.
And now they're protesting against Israel in favor of Gaza or whatever you want to call Palestina.
Well, most of them, I think, are protesting because they feel like the Israeli response has been too heavy-handed, that the bombing has been indiscriminate.
Well, if you went to war like they did, you know, if they go into your country, they slaughter you, and they want to exterminate you, you've got two options. Either you stay behind and get killed, or you go all the way to the end. You know, I will go all the way to the end, because if you go halfway, they're going to rebuild themselves.
But what about all of the relatives of the people who are killed? The sisters, the brothers, the parents, the children who will say, Israel murdered my family, regardless of whether it was a war, and now I'm going to avenge that, and I'm going to carry out the next October 7th. Isn't there a danger of that?
Well, it's a pity that innocent people have been killed. You know, we cannot hide that. There were a lot of kids, women, innocent people that they're there and they've been killed. But on the other side, you will see that Hamas has been hiding in hospitals. And what do you do? You know, you cannot select who's who or what's what.
Do you support Hamas?
I do not support Hamas, no, at all. I know that there are figures on the left that support Hamas very blindly and very ignorantly.
People from Palestine should turn around and say to Hamas, because of you, you know, we're all being killed.
Are you supportive of Hamas?
I am not supportive of Hamas, no.
You look at the entire course of these protests, the escalation has not only come from the student side, it has also come from the administration side. They've not been negotiating in good faith. They're supposed to be the adults in the room. They're supposed to be the ones that are taking a step back, thinking strategically about what should happen in this situation for the university. And instead, they've disregarded the views of students, but they also haven't consulted with faculty who have expertise, including myself and my colleagues, in the dynamics of protest and social movements and backlash to cracking down on things. We could have told them this would have happened, but they weren't listening to faculty.
Well, it really happened as a response to police action on campus a few weeks ago. At that point, the protest was significantly smaller than what it was now. There were just a couple of students on the South Lawn. You know, once the police actually intervened, then students actually became mobilized.
I think that the concerns of people on all sides of this conflict are sincere. The concerns of the protesters are sincere. The concerns of some Jewish students who said they were unsafe are sincere. But the way a social movement works, if you crack down on it, it gets bigger, and that should have been anticipated.
And I think anti-Semitism is real, and I do think it's on campus. I also think that mentioning Islamophobia doesn't negate that.
They should have mentioned, they never mentioned these protesters. Yes, they did wrong on the 7th of, yes, they did. But now what is this? So to somehow to connect these two things, you know, otherwise it's just one-sided and they're all like pro-Palestinians. They should be saying the Jews suffer too. So they're both parties suffer. It's not countable, one less, the other more.
On one hand, I'm really supportive of, you know, of student activism, of student protests, but I get really worried when, you know, when they're blockading things and making it difficult to cross, I guess. And I see some of the videos that are being circulated around of some of the things that are being said, and as a Jew, they scare me. on the other hand, I don't really know who to trust because a lot of the people circulating these things are generally sources I don't really trust, you know, generally like, you know, right-wing leaning places that I feel like, I don't feel like they're genuinely committed to the safety of Jewish people. I feel like they're tokenizing us and just to own the libs or whatever.
When Fox News says like, oh, it's like a pro-Hamas encampment, like I don't think that's true. I think you're blowing out of proportion.
To focus on one or two incidents of legitimate anti-Semitism and projecting it to the entire student movement would be a gross mischaracterization of what's going on here.
I find myself flip-flopping every day because I do want to protest the wrongdoings of Israel, but I do wonder why aren't people my age mobilized this way for, you know, the tons of other issues like you know the Russia-Ukraine war or abortion. I was really hoping that like when Roe was struck down that we would have like this big movement for taking back our bodily autonomy, and I don't know, I guess like I'm just jealous on a causal. I'm no organizer or anything, so I guess if I want to do that, I should do that myself.
Well, how do you explain, though, the fact that this is getting a lot of attention and those issues like abortion rights, women's reproductive freedoms are not getting what you had hoped for? I mean, why is it that this breaks through?
I'm not sure. That's why I can't help but, like, you know, fall back and wonder if there is some ingrained anti-Semitism in people, even people who don't know. I think it's just people who are not questioning why is this getting all the attention? Why is this getting, or maybe it's, I've heard some arguments that it's because the US funds Israel, you know, we're not funding Russia, we're not funding China or anything. But on the other hand, there are still tons of things at home that I feel like we would have more impact on.
Have you thought at all about joining the protests one way or the other?
No, and that's not to say that I don't support or not support the protest, but you know, again, I don't feel educated enough to get involved.
You know, the main goal here is to establish a political system in which there's equal rights, irrespective of religion or national origin.
The complaint about the protesters is that they're holding Israel to a higher standard than anybody else, and therefore that makes some of the Jewish students and the Israeli students uncomfortable. Any validity to that?
Nah. Whatever I say, however I say it, there are different opinions. There are millions of opinions.
I think the problems are much more nuanced than what a lot of people make them to be. So I think right now it's kind of like a very like one side or the other. But I think in reality it's kind of like it's a very complicated situation. And when you're making a binary action like to remove people or not to remove people, it's you can't really capture those. Like, you're going to offend one side or the other, and I think it's really hard to make a good choice.
You know, like, I think a more nuanced approach is the solution. Yes.
And how come we can't have that? How come it seems like and it feels like there are such extremes on both sides that are driving us?
Yeah, part of it is, let's say, money interest is involved in both sides, so there's always people looking to profit from war. And people are stuck in their own ways, so it's like we have to show people that, you know, both Jews and Muslims are welcome.
This would definitely leave a stain on Columbia for sure for a little while, and it would definitely take a while to get the, you know, the hearts and, you know, the true feelings of the student body back for sure, because you left a lot of students unhappy on both sides. So, you know, when you make both sides unhappy, it's very hard to regain trust and get that. So I am curious to see how things will roll out into the fall. But, I mean, we'll just see how admin and the president moves on. I mean, I think the best thing right now is just to end the school year without any more chaos being created.